It was almost spring on the island of Sodor, and all the engines were busy. They were looking forward to the warm weather coming soon.
Oh, what a big snowdrift.
The engines who look forward to spring most of all are Luke and Henry, as their favorite places, the forested meadow, will soon be filled with blooming spring flowers and animals coming back from hibernation. One day, Thomas had just finished his morning's work and was puffing back to the sheds, but he wasn't the only one there.
Morning, everyone. Oh, James, not again. James! James, wake up! What's going on?
What's up, James? You've been making noises in your sleep lately!
Oh, that's been having a bad dream, that's all.
What was it you were dreaming of?
Oh, it doesn't matter, really. What are you two up to today? Well, today is the day of a big show at Natford Station, and me and Percy are to take some passengers from our branch line to take them to the show. This one is about when the railway was first built.
Why? What are you doing today, James? Taking passengers? Pulling trucks? Or are you waiting around the sheds until me and Thomas go out so you can go back to your mushy dream of yours?
How do you know these things? Who told you these things? Are you a member of the occult?
What did you just call me?
A member of the occult. Alright, that's enough, you two. Listen, I've got a call from Finn. Dumb the grubby man is back and has stolen something from a Natford exhibition, and it's on the run right now. Leave it to me, Thomas. James is on the case.
And James raced out of the sheds as fast as he could. James soon caught up with Vin, Holly, and the grubby man's car, but he was going too fast.
You'll never catch me on this one. Oh, we'll see about that. Come on, team. We can do this. James, you better slow down. Don't worry, Holly. I can take him from here.
Then, there was trouble.
Are you all right, James?
I think so.
Ah, no, I'm not. My paintwork is ruined.
Well, I did tell you to go slowly.
I know. But what about Dumb? Vent to Holly. I've got him. He was heading to the fuel tank, but I've stopped him.
Bad news, Vent. Over. James had demolished the old special workshop. Over.
Right. We'll postpone the celebrations until we can find time to build a new one. Over and out. Well, at least things can't get any worse.
Oh!
Thank you.
the narrow gauge mission. To run a railway like the one on Sodor, you have to make sure an engine is ready to take on any job, whether it was goods trains or pulling passengers. But the most dangerous one, hauling wagons filled with dangerous gadgets or munitions. Edward had just delivered some empty trucks to the storage shed, but it had been a rough journey thanks to the trucks, and if that wasn't enough, he had to suffer Roger, the diesel engine who acts like he's in the army.
Attention! Attention! You, Edward!
Attention nothing. I've finished here and now I'm moving out.
Oh no you don't, not to like check things out.
Well, check all you like. I'm needed on my own branch line.
You're under army room inspections. Obey orders and await my inspections.
Engines like me obey orders, but we only take them from the fat controller. Not from an engine who thinks they can take charge whenever they want.
Haha, we'll see about that, laddie. Edward, hey, stay where you are, it's an order. I'll show the engines a thing or two, and then they'll know what orders are all about.
Further down on the line, Edward saw Vogel, and he told him all about Roger.
Roger can really drive an engine mad. Orders come before common sense in military terms.
He ordered me about as well, Edward. Keep those trucks in line, he shouts, and report to me when you finish, he added. Yes, I haven't done this job before.
Well, Boko, I better be off. I'm going to the coaling plant for a rest and to fill up my tender.
The next engine to meet Roger was Toby.
Get a move on you, slow coach, and keep those wagons in line. What are you, a tram or a tortoise? I'll check out your wagons when I've done my inspection. We should work together, not fight each other. And I never thought when I was a young tram engine.
Wow! What's inside those crates, boss?
Well, Kevin, inside those crates are special upgrades for us rescue team. Belle, Flynn and Med are all good at fighting fire with water, but they don't squirt foam.
Foam?
Yes, Kevin. Foam. And more to the point, sticky foam.
Sticky foam? Oh, I like the sound of that.
Yes, Kevin. We spray the foam and it sticks to the surface, so that the fire can't spread.
Well, that definitely sounds really useful.
Thanks, Duck.
The next morning, James was still trying to find out who was responsible for his accident.
All right, who left the motty tortoise on the tracks? Thomas? Percy? Massa? Jeez, calm down, James. Besides, it wasn't me or Percy who left something like a tortoise on the tracks. Hey guys, what's up? James thinks it was us that left a tortoise on the track which caused him to crash into the special workshop yesterday. Ah, speaking of tortoise, have you seen it? Oh, so it's your tortoise, is it? Not really. My driver was looking after it for the scrapyard manager. Oh no! Oh no! That's which the scrapyard manager's pet tortoise! Now I'm sure to be scrapped! Goodbye, old pal! You're good friends! Oh Lord, spare me! Would it be possible if you could leave my dome in its place? James? Oh, what is it, Graham? Can't you see I'm panicking? Well, I was only joking. What? Yeah, I was trying to get back at you for last Christmas, so I hatched a plan which I hoped would scratch your paint. Well, it bloody well worked! Look at me! Don't worry, I can see that from here. It's not even a real tortoise. Look, it's my driver's great uncle, Second World War helmet, that was glued to the tracks. You complete prankster! That's right, James. You're just having another day in paradise. I am not. You take that back, out. What's going on here? Oh, morning, sir. James ran over my driver's uncle's helmet and... That's because he left it there! Well, oh my, that's enough! I've already heard the whole thing from my car. Graham, on your way now. And you two stop teasing each other. Yes, sir. See you later, Jamie, you stupid red sod. And I'm sorry about the workshop, guys. I've really let you down, haven't I?
That's okay, James. We're planning to build a new one anyway.
A new one?
Yes, Percy. The new one was started to get a bit small for all our gadgets and inventions. So we are going to build Sodor's very own secret agency. And we've asked Sir Topham Hatt to see if some of you can help us. And I thought it would be a great idea. It all sounds brilliant. I can't wait to get started. That's good, Thomas, because you are one of four engines that will be helping with the work. And the other three are Percy, James, and Henry. Dudley will also be helping out at some point as well. Henry, you'll be in charge of the cranes, which means you'll be helping for most of the work. James, you'll be delivering the building materials. And Thomas and Percy, you two will be transporting the gadgets and inventions from the shunting yard to the new agency. But it won't be until the building work is finished, so until then, you'll be helping out at the Blue Mountain Quarry, which is not far from the site, so you can come over if the others need extra help. Dudley will help out if either one of the jobs, if needed. Yes, sir!
But who's going to do our work on our branch line?
Well, Percy, Toby will look after Annie and Claribel, with Henrietta. Stepney will be coming over from the Bluebell Railway to look after your mail train, as he will be visiting for the next few days, and Derek will help you out at the shunting yard too. Oh, great. This means I'll have to put up with more fumes from Derek. I can't stand that diesel. He's just a useless piece of junk.
Oh, yeah? Well, why don't you take a plane, Kim, if you don't want to see any more diesel engines?
Me? Why would he... let's talk from you, James. Or you will be pulling the flying kipper instead. Now go and collect your trucks for your slow goods train. What a start of a day.
And after yards, James collected his trucks while Brian and Dylan were being coupled up to Gordon's coaches, so they could shunt them to the station for him. James was still feeling very cross. Things hadn't been going his way all morning. And then, things got worse.
Oi, you in red. You're in my way, man. Get moving, that's an order. Oi, you army twit. You nearly scratched my tender. I gave an order to move out of my way. This railway is the most unpleasant I've ever worked in. Now get a move on. Spencer, Diesel 10 and his gang are all bad enough, but Roger is something else. Well, at least he'll be gone tomorrow, so I won't have to put up with him. Small mercies. Guess what, guys? Me and Percy are going to help you all at the Blue Mountain Quarry starting tomorrow. The others are going to be helping out with Sodor's very own secret agency. What a question to ask! We all been helping out with Finn and Holly on their ancient missions. I helped Finn to stop Professor C from taking over the world in the desert, which is not on Sodor. Yes, that's right, James. You even helped Dudley on his first day and stopped Diesel 10 and the trucks with mind control chips.
What about the time when you rescued Dowager Hatt's dog Gremlin from that burning warehouse last year? That was pretty brave. I don't think I could have done it. Mind you, I'm not as stupid as you are.
Wow, being an agent sounds really cool. I bet it would be great if I could go on the mission too. I would be able to chase robbers, solve crimes, and if I get the chance, I would be able to stop hunters from attacking the wildlife. Kapow!
Duncan! Luke doesn't like your stories.
Pah! Well, it's not my fault if Luke's not as brave or clever as I am. He's just a young engine!
I'm not a coward!
Well, if you're so brave, Duncan, go on an agent mission and show what you can do.
Doing agent missions aren't short for standard gate big engines like us, not for tiny toy little engines like you.
Too small? Well, I could even catch a crook without demolishing a building!
Alright, you're on.
Alright, that's enough, you two. Sorry about this, guys. I don't know what's up with him today. I think it's best me all get back to work.
You really should take those two seriously. Although doing an agent mission would make a nice change, wouldn't it? What's the matter? I mean, you usually enjoy working here.
I know I'm not a scaredy inch, Rheneas. I just don't know how to prove it.
Hey, I've got an idea that might take your fancy. How about you and me have another race to the crushing shed? I'm sure that'll cheer you up.
Okay, Rheneas. Let's get started.
Way up into the mountain, hear the rumble and chop. Wheels grinding and growling, and funnels pop. Got to work harder, shift that slate. Got to go faster, can't be late. Here we come, up the hill, there we go. And whirring, pull that load. Working through to the sunset every day. Trying hard to be useful.